of economic cooperation and development. That's where the jobs are going. So we're looking at an effective unemployment rate, as you well know, it's 17.5%. When you put long-term discouraged into it, it's 26%. Our greatest fear, I should say concern, not a fear, our greatest concern is the growing underclass in America. And to us, this is where the money should really start going into. And we're not talking about play money here. Because what you have is you have in major cities, half these kids are not even graduating high school. And they're born into families, so the grace of God, any of us who were born into, we would have the same miserable lives that they're born into. Parents on crack and meth and you name it, hopeless people with no past, no present, and no future. So these kids, what are they going to do to earn a living? They don't have those manufacturing jobs anymore. They're going to become, the best job they're going to find is in a gang. And that's our greatest concern. And we're going to start seeing crime rates in this country that are going to go off the charts. And, of course, the moronic politicians are going to say, we have to get tough on crime, which means taking more constitutional rights away from the rest of us and turning it into a police state as if it isn't already. So those are the concerns that we're, that are facing us. I mean, what would anybody do if they had, you know, grew up like this? Would crime is the easy way out. So that's to us is where a lot of the direction should go. And what we're doing here at the Trends Research Institute is we're working on programs. We're in upstate New York, about 2 hours north of New York City, is to start getting these kids out of the city and putting them on farms so they can work with their hands and their heads and do something constructive. You know, even the peasants knew how to mend a fence. They knew how when to plant, when to harvest. And that's what we need to do. We need to get people doing things again that are going to be productive. So it's not gloom and doom. It's only gloom and doom if we continue to go in the direction that the government's taking us in.
What about these expanding tent cities, Gerald? These are not your typical homeless. These people have had jobs and a roof over their heads their whole life. What are your thoughts as you see that?
Well, as we've said, when we forecast the panic of 08 back in 2007, one of the things we said that self-storage units are going to take on the true meaning of their name. People will be storing themselves in it. And the same thing with the tent cities. There are people losing their jobs that have absolutely nothing to go back to. They've lost, thanks to the Goldman Sachs gangs and the Merrill Lynch mobs, they've lost their pensions, they've lost their retirement, they've lost their investments. They were told that they have a diversified portfolio. Yeah, diversified. So now, yeah, it's really diversified into nothing. So they have nothing. And we're going to see increases of mental health problems and many, many other terrible, terrible social, economic, and political issues befalling America. Again, it's only going to increase. The stimulus programs are a qualified bust. Let's just get it straight. If we made as many wrong forecasts as Bernanke, Bush, and Obama and the rest of them, we would have been out of business 30 years ago when we started. And what Obama promised was that with the stimulus program, without it, without the stimulus program, we're going to see unemployment, without it, hit 8% in 2009. All right, now we got it, and unemployment, official unemployment, is at 10.2. Oh, and if we don't get that stimulus package in 2010, unemployment could hit 9%. Oh, yeah, right. It'll probably be hitting over 12% in 2010. So everything they say is wrong, and what they're saying about the plans for the future are wrong. Every one of their forecasts have been wrong. There is no stimulus program. It stimulates their pals. That's it. And they throw a couple of crumbs. Look at the crumbs Obama threw to the elderly because the fixed numbers, the rigged numbers, didn't show an increase in cost of living. He said, we're going to give everybody $250, all those elderly folks out there, the 15 million of them, 50 million of them. Oh, great. $250, 50 million people. Hey, that comes out to $13 billion, the same amount of money we gave to the Goldman Sachs gang to cover their bad bets with AIG. It's crumbs for the little people, big payoffs for their buddies.
Let's stick with Bernanke for just a minute. There was a lot of praise heaped on Bernanke by economists for pulling the economy out of its worst crisis since the 1930s. From the Autumn Trends Journal, quote, "The economy was pulled out of its worst crisis. Only the too big to fail were pulled out, and the economy was temporarily titillated." What about, end quote, what about these moves that Bernanke has made? Who really benefited, and where are we really in this economy, Gerald?
Well, we know who benefited. These bank holding companies, the big guys, borrow money at zero and then loan it out at higher interest rates to businesses and governments. And by the way, this is a global stimulus, and it's just propping up and building another bubble. We called it the bailout bubble when it began under Bush. And when the bailout bubble bursts, it'll be the bubble of all bubbles. Bernanke, I mean, they're just printing phantom money out of thin air based on nothing and producing nothing. And that's why the dollar's diving and gold is going up. But the whole world is doing it. They're all caught in the same game. And when the stimulus runs out, the pain will set in. It's like giving someone with a chronic degenerative disease an allotropic drug. There's no drug on the market that cures a chronic degenerative disease. It only eases the pain for a little bit. It relieves the symptoms. And that's what this is. The stimulus is symptom relief. It doesn't cure the problem. When the after effects of the money drugs wear off, the greatest depression will set in, and it's going to be worldwide. No one will escape it. World trade is down 25%. It's not going to increase. The only thing we're having now is a temporary respite from all the stimulus money being pumped in by the world economies, the central banks. And that's why we're strong believers in gold 2000. Not only is the U.S. currency going down, so too will many others, as more and more people bail out of paper and want the real thing.
I have two final questions for you here to close, Gerald. Government at the local, state, and federal level are trying anything they can to squeeze money out of people. When is there going to be a new round of tax protests, Gerald? And will there be more and more people turning against the government in the future?
The new tax protests are going to start. I should say they're never going to stop. Taxation without representation was the cause of the first American Revolution, and it will be the rallying cry of the second. People cannot be squeezed anymore. Parking tickets, license fees. And by the way, what's killing this country is the too big to fail deals that they get in tax breaks while the entrepreneur gets hit left and right by the state and local governments. They squeeze them any way they can. They regulate them to death while they give the big guys the big breaks. Hey, you need a loan guarantee? How about some tax breaks? Maybe we could build you some infrastructure improvements as long as you're big and the little people are all paying for it.